Soil organic matter is one of the most important parts of your soil. Without soil organic matter, plants really struggle to grow well, and the soil doesn't have good structure, doesn't hold water well, and doesn't cycle its nutrients. We're going to look at soil organic matter, where it comes from, how it forms. It might help you to understand better how to manage or improve the soil organic levels on your place. The first thing to know about soil organic matter is where it comes from. And soil organic matter story starts with these guys, with plants. Plants do that really important thing for all of us, and that's photosynthesis. Photosynthesis is where plants grab carbon out of the air. They combine that with water and nutrients that they've taken up from the soil, and plants create plant biomass. When plants grow, they create different types of organic matter or organic biomass. They create this hard woody material, which is high in carbon and in lignin, and they also create this soft leafy stuff, which breaks down much more easy. It's not just happening above ground. We can see lots of plant material and cane trash and mulch above the ground or hitting the soil and contributing to organic matter. The same thing's happening underground. All of the roots of plants are contributing to your soil's organic matter below the ground as well. So when all this organic matter hits the soil, what happens to it? Well, there's two basic things. The stuff that's easily broken down, that stuff that's low in carbon, tends to decompose quite quickly, and most of the carbon in it gets breathed off or respired off by all the microbes in the soil that eat it up. The second part of your organic matter, the really woody stuff, tends to break down more slowly, and actually some of it ends up being what we call humus. Humus is the long-term soil organic matter that gives the soil a nice dark colour. So you really need both the short-term digestible organic matter and you need some long-term humus. They're both parts of the soil organic matter story. Farming systems that improve their organic matter often see real benefits. The first one is it helps to create soil structure. The second thing it does is it drives the nutrient cycling in your soil. Without organic matter, nutrient cycling and the management of fertilizers is really problematic. And in fact, the leaking and loss of nutrients from your farm is increased as your organic matter levels lower. The third real benefit is that it allows your soil biology to really thrive. Finally, having good levels of humus in your soil helps build resilience and plant health. This means that in dry periods and in flooding periods, the plants and the crops are able to bounce back better. So how much soil organic matter do you actually need? As a general rule of thumb, at least 2.5% soil organic matter is a minimum target to set. We're in a vanilla plantation here in the wet tropics, and this soil here has an organic matter level of nearly 20%. That's really high, and it's been achieved through mulching over time. The results have been impressive for the farm business. And it's a great example of why soil organic matter is so important to you, whether you're in sugarcane, bananas, tropical fruits, or grazing. Well, the first thing to do is set yourself a target. The second thing you need to do is start to monitor soil organic matter. And the main way to do that is to use a soil test. The next thing is to put in place some practices to help build and maintain soil organic matter. Add organic matter to your soil. Things like mill mud, mill ash, compost, mulch. And the big one you can do is to reduce tillage. When you till the soil, you pretty much just put all the decomposition into turbo and they break down all that organic matter even faster. Another big factor that influences your organic matter is the amount of nitrogen you put out. When you add a lot of nitrogen to your topsoil, that really stimulates all the microbes in your soil and they will start to decompose at a faster rate. So really trying to reduce your nitrogen-based fertilizers a bit and target your nitrogen management better is an important step in managing your soil's organic matter. One of the biggest things you can do is try to keep living cover on your paddocks for as much as possible through the year. And it's the root volume of the cover crops that's probably more important than the material and the trash on the surface. So if you want to learn more about how to build organic matter in your soil, then contact your local extension agronomist or Terrain or follow the links at the end of this video.